There are so many good roguelike or roguelite games, and this time, I will share with you guys 15 must-play roguelike hidden gems. Let's get into the list. Okay, we are starting the list with a really weird-looking game. Black Gunner Wukong is a bullet hell roguelite game that stands out with its unique and entertaining twist on the genre. While the game could benefit from some optimization, it offers a lot of fun at a low price. It's simple and enjoyable to play. You control a six-armed hero causing chaos in a military base, shooting at everything on screen by rotating the camera and occasionally attacking with a huge stick. The video trailer shows the game packed with humorous moments. I guess the game looks so abstract that it could fall into the so bad it's good category. Doomsday Hunters is a roguelite game with extensive customizations, loot, and twin-stick combat. The game offers a wide variety of weapons and hunters, ensuring great replay value. On top of that, the gameplay is fast-paced with a decent level of difficulty, relying more on player skill than item drops and perks. Overall, this game is a fun roguelite. The developer's passion is evident, making it deserving of more attention from fans of fast-paced twin-stick roguelite shooters. Vault of the Void is a fantastic roguelike deck builder. Instead of reinventing the deck building genre that Slay the Spire started, it refines and polishes it, packing in so much content you can't resist. The game offers a balanced design with diverse playstyles. The developer also continuously updates the game with balanced and free updates even after it's considered finished, a huge plus in today's gaming world. If you are a fan of roguelike deck builders, there's no reason not to try this game. Empty Shell is a top-down roguelite shooter where death is inevitable. Whether you get swarmed by giant monsters or run out of ammo mid-fight, it's only a matter of time before you meet your end. The black and white aesthetic with an old CRT filter on this game really enhanced the game's unnerving atmosphere. Coupled with the constant threat of sudden enemy attacks from off-screen, the game will always keep you on the edge. Pikayon Dreams is a survivor-like game that stands out by adding unique features and flavor to keep things interesting. For instance, a fast-forward button allows the game to run at double speed, making early waves more exciting. The game's flavor is also exceptional. I guess what I can say is its graphics are fantastically weird. If you are a fan of Vampire Survivors-like game, I highly recommend Pikayon Dreams. It's creative, engaging, and offers a lot for just $5. Spirit's Abyss is a fantastically packed roguelite twin-stick action game, with familiar graphics for anyone who has played other games by the same developer. The game features destructible environments and downward progression, moving from zone to zone that feel similar with Spelunky, offering a challenging experience though it has its own unique elements. Spirit's Abyss is a special game with a lot of personality and content, rewarding those who invest the time to uncover its secrets. Voidigo stands out in the roguelite shooter genre, with its unique aesthetic and innovative twist. Instead of a dodge roll, you jump over threats and stomp on enemies' heads to stun them, creating a chainable bunny hop. As you progress through the game, you will unlock numerous upgrades that adds exciting effects, like explosions or swarms of bats and snakes that attack your enemies. While it may not dethrone Nuclear Throne as the top roguelite shooter, Voidigo's distinctiveness and fun gameplay make it a game that highly recommend. Force Reboot is an excellent fast-paced roguelite FPS that delivers the speed and adrenaline of classic shooter games. It requires quick reaction rather than a cautious approach to survive, earning it the label of typical boomer shooter. Currently in early access, Force Reboot offers 3 playable modes, including Rush Mode for faster-paced action and endless mode for extended playthrough. Despite its early stage, the game show promise as a worthy addition to the boomer shooter genre. Cryptarch is a challenging roguelike shooter where you pilot different mechs, each with its own weapons, to destroy cores protected by enemies. The game boasts visually stunning graphics with a cartoony style that suits it well. From the giant space hulks to the tiny repair bots, everything looks fantastic. Like I said, the game is challenging and demands strategic thinking. While it's enjoyable for twin stick shooter fans, those who appreciate strategic planning will find it particularly rewarding. Archfell is a top-down bullet hell roguelike game with charming pixel-style graphics. Your mission in this game is to explore procedurally generated worlds and rooms to collect items, materials, badge, and upgrades needed to find the 7 archpiece and face the final boss. The graphics, animations, and music are excellent, and the gameplay mechanics are solid. Overall, Archfell is an awesome game worth playing. With around 10 hours of gameplay per playthrough, it offers good value for its quality. Shogun Showdown is one of the most clever turn-based roguelikes. Even in early access, the game features satisfying controls, tight and engaging combat, and a great variety of encounters and weapons. Every encounter feels like a dance as you navigate enemy attacks, finding the right time to prepare and strike. If you enjoy turn-based roguelikes and want something fresh and unique, you should definitely check out this game. Devil Slayer: Rakshasi is more than a typical top-down roguelike. It combines Binding of Isaac-style randomized rooms with Souls-like melee combat. The combat is precise and timing-based. You manage stamina and mana, and each character has unique skills and attributes. In this game, death is common and part of the learning process, with souls of defeated enemies used for upgrades. All in all, the game offers a unique and memorable roguelike experience, with deep melee combat and extensive content. Despite some grind and minor issues, it's a polished game that deserves more attention. Revita is not just a good game, it's an excellent roguelike. It's a blend of risk-reward mechanics, strategic depth, and engaging gameplay, making it a standout title in the genre. The game features platforming dungeon-crawling shooter-style combat. As the unnamed protagonist, you wield a soul gun to dispatch enemies, using dash for evasion and soul bar to manage health. The game is visually stunning, and the music also complements the aesthetic. It really elevates the overall experience of the game. At first, this game might seem like a visual mess, but boy was I wrong. Mortal Sin is an incredibly solid roguelike. The combat system is actually complex and deeply satisfying, especially when you chain combos together seamlessly. Even when facing tough enemy crowds, mastering the combat gives you a sense of control and accomplishment. Mortal Sin is amazing. I'm eager to see this game fully released from early access. Brutal Orchestra is a tribute to creativity. Inspired by the art of Hieronymus Bosch, the game cleverly integrates reference to his work. The game also offers innovative mechanics that turn battles into engaging puzzles. You can anticipate enemy move and their order, but the complexity arises from the interaction between attacks and the ability to shuffle positions. It's a refreshing approach to turn-based combat that adds depth and strategy. I can say that this is one of the best hidden gem roguelike that everyone should know about. That's all for today's list. Subscribe and like for more new exciting roguelike games. That's it, and see you next time.